Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to this nursing educational video. I am Ayub, working in intensive care unit. Today I'm going to educate you how to perform endotracheal tube sectioning on critically ill patient. The purpose of this procedure is to clear secretion and maintain patent airway in order to optimize oxygenation and ventilation. First of all, this procedure can be performed in two techniques, open section and closed sectioning system. In this video, we are going to explain about two techniques. Before starting this procedure, we should assess airway patency by checking saturation, heart rate and respiratory rate, and auscultate both lungs for any abnormal breathing sounds such as crackles and crepitations. Additionally, the nurse should look for any sign of respiratory discomfort such as obvious secretion inside ET tubes, and some patients will produce audible noisy breathing sound while coughing. After making sure that patient requires sectioning, we should prepare our supply and make sure that all equipments are functioning well. The supplies are functioning wall section unit with suction tubing connected, clean and sterile gloves, water for irrigation, and suction catheter sealed in a protective plastic sleeve. For open suction technique, first explain the procedure to the patient. Then set the suction pressure at low vacuum pressure between 100 to 120 millimeter of mercury. Perform hand hygiene. Open suction catheter from the top. Check pre-suction physiological parameters and pre-oxygenate the patient. Wear sterile gloves. Keep the ventilator in standby mode, then disconnect ventilator tubing from the ET tube. Connect suction catheter with suction tubing. Make sure to keep dominant hand sterile. Pass the suction catheter inside the ET tube until resistance is met. Start to do suctioning by applying intermittent negative pressure. Gently rotate the suction catheter as it's being withdrawn from the ET tube. Discard suction catheter. Use water for irrigation to clear secretion from suction tubing. Turn off vacuum pressure. Document on patient's EBR for the amount, color and consistency of the secretion. The second type of endotracheal tube sectioning is closed section technique. The advantages of this technique are preventing catheter being contaminated and reducing the number of disconnection from ventilator to avoid further hypoxia. This procedure is performed as following. First, explain the procedure to the patient. Set the suction pressure at low vacuum pressure between 100 to 120 millimeter of mercury. Perform hand washing. Observe pre-suction physiological parameters and pre-oxygenate the patient. Wear clean gloves. Connect suction catheter with suction tubing. Pass suction catheter inside the plastic sleeve until resistance is met. Start to do suctioning by applying intermittent negative pressure. Gently rotate suction catheter as it's being withdrawn from the ET tube. Inject 3 to 5 ml of normal saline inside ET port to clear suction catheter inside closed system. Use water for irrigation to clear secretion from suction tubing. Turn off vacuum pressure. Document in patient's EBR for the amount, color and consistency of the secretions. Before ending this educational video, I want to highlight following points. Frequency of suctioning should be conducted based on patient's condition and assessment findings. Installation of normal saline inside ET tube to loosen secretion is not recommended. Intermittent negative pressure should only be applied once suction catheter is being withdrawn from ET tube. The duration of negative pressure should not exceed 10 seconds to avoid hypoxia. This is the end of this nursing education video. Yes?
Your patient requires suction.
Okay, thank you for watching this video.